history is pretty wild. So for this one, for this part two, we had to get a little bit creative to say, I don't know. Welcome back to Bumblebee. Here are the top 10 normal things from history that are too woke for this era. Part two, it's gonna get pretty weird. Let's do it. Kicking off the list at number 10, Animal Court. Imagine if Judge Judy did Animal Court. Do you understand how much money I would pay a month to see Judge Judy do this? Buckle up, guys. Animal Court. Yeah, I'd say this part of medieval history, this is my favorite. Nobody's losing heads. Nobody has to wipe the king's bottom. It's just animals being put on trial. Simple as that. I'm not even talking about the Salem witch trials also, by the way. That's a completely separate thing. I mean, if animals would break the law, they would have to show up to court and face the music. There were reportedly 85 animal trials that took place during the Middle Ages. It's a lot of trials. It's a lot of time for an animal to be on the stand. That's incredible. They're mentioned in the book Criminal Prosecution and Capital Punishments of Animals by E.P. Evans. Just a wild book in general, definitely check it out. Pigs were more often than not the bad boys of the barn because they would bite humans, right? They would rip off body parts sometimes. So they would be found guilty and then sentenced to death. One of two things would happen at this point. They would burn them at the stake, which is just what making food, I guess, or they would hang them, which is just so sad. Either way, it's pretty horrible. When I was in high school, I took law. We went to like real courts to observe and whatnot. Imagine going on a field trip, going to real courts, and then you see this. Comedy? No. I'm for sure studying law after today. Number 9, pointed shoes. Whenever I see medieval anything for that matter, I always admire the shoes. What are those? What are those? I hate buying shoes today. They're so specific in size and style. Walking shoes, running shoes, trail shoes. They're so expensive and they don't last long at all. I've never seen a new UGG, you know what I mean? They're always salty, they're always broken, just horrible footwear, right? Nobody does it like the medieval times anymore, specifically Krakows. Krakows were a style of shoe commonly worn in the 15th century in Europe, and they look ridiculous. Maybe that's why I love them, I don't know. Long-toed shoes first appeared in the 12th century, but the Krakow, this thing was twice as long as your foot sometimes, just so stupid. These meant business, apparently. Better watch your ankles, Beth. Take those things right out. People would for sure trip over these things. Why were they so long? And why did they keep coming back over and over in time? Who brought these back? Named after the city they were made in, Krakows were worn by everybody. But as cheeky as it sounds, the longer the shoe, the more valuable you were. So now it turned into a joke all of a sudden. People wearing these massive shoes that just look stupid. Shoes that were three times as long as your foot sometimes. That's not cool. There's no way Carol from Clifton Castle is looking at your shoes being like, oh my God, who is he? No, that's not how it works. That's ridiculous. You ever walk around in pool flippers? You do that big silly walk? That's the walk you would do in these. No one's looking cool in Krakows. They would be stuffed, of course, because that would be pretty hilarious if they weren't just flopping around all over the place. They'd be stuffed with horsehair or moss. A little bit different than Dr. Scholl. But the insane part here is that these things were so long, a string would be needed to be tied from the tip of the shoe to your knee so they don't, you know, flop over. Had that cool curve. I'm gonna be the first guy to moonwalk in a Krakow. That's when I'll get TikTok. Number 8, a scribe. I kicked off this part two with animal courts, but one thing we don't see as often anymore, and I sure wish we did, was a scribe. Scribes would copy text, something that would take months. You ever read the terms and conditions to an iPhone? Imagine life before copy and paste. You had to write that out one by one, one word at a time. It was a process. I mean, first you had to convince somebody to let you borrow their codex for months at a time, which was a process that comes at a high cost. A lot of trust there for sure. I'd let my friends borrow my phone chargers, let alone my codex. Know what I mean? Many didn't know how to write, and to be fair, if I magically got transported back to the Middle Ages right now, they wouldn't be able to read my chicken scratch. Also, ink, like dipping and doing that, no way, I can't do that. If you dabbled in calligraphy, imagine this. Imagine you have to write out the speech of a drunk king. Go. So much ink everywhere, so wet. Number 7, divorce by combat. If you've seen Game of Thrones, you've heard of trial by combat, but what about divorce by combat? Yeah, what in the Mr. and Mrs. Smith is going on here? If you and your significant other weren't getting along in medieval Germany, instead of dishing out thousands of dollars on couples therapy or, you know, talking things out, they would scrap it out. It wasn't just one couple fighting in front of like 8 dudes also, it was organized. It had restrictions in place for the husband. He had to stand in a hole with one hand tied behind his back, while the wife ran around in circles around the hole with a sack full of rocks. I think I'd rather have my wife use the chair. A sack of rocks? Are you kidding me? Just take the barn, take the horse, take it all. I don't want it. Don't hit me with a sack of rocks. I'm dizzy. Where are you? Number 6, face it. The amount of makeup tutorials on YouTube nowadays is great. You can achieve any look you desire overnight. All you have to do is follow along. Hell, maybe you can listen to a murder mystery while you even do it. It's great. It's easy. Easy, he says. I can't even, no way. I can't grow facial hair, so I don't have to worry about trimming anything at all, ever. I'm still doing No Shave November, know what I mean? Meanwhile, Andrew's got the Viking look going on. Guy's a new beard every time I see him. Just nothing but men with beard all around me, and I'm like, hey, Mr. Dove Soap guy. Back in the Middle Ages, I would have been set. The forehead was seen as the central point of your face. Like, hi, this right here, boom. So it was common for individuals to pluck their eyelashes and remove their eyebrows completely. Many would go as far as to pluck their hairline as well, so they have the round, oval, bald look. Imagine in Game of Thrones, season 5, everybody was just bald, had no eyebrows. Do you think we'd get used to it, or do you think season 5 would be like, hey, can we give Macy Williams eyebrows? She's a wonderful actor, she needs to emote, come on. We don't need to be historically accurate for season 5, please. Number 5, the knocker upper. It's not what you think, just to say that off the bat. This truly is the dream job. Let me ask you, we're a couple weeks into the new year now. Have you woken up late yet? Has it happened? Have you been good? I've been late twice so far and I was working from home. Yeah, it happens. You don't hear alarms sometimes, or sometimes you just forget to set it entirely. So back in the day, just how did people wake up on time for work? The knocker upper, that's who. Well, the knocker upper, he'd come around and knock you up. I think there's different ways to say that. Kicking off in Ireland around the early 19th century, knocker-uppers are exactly what you'd guess. They carry a big, long stick, and they would tap on your window. Sorry, when I say tap, I mean they'd be like, poof, and then wake you up, just jarringly, now you're awake. Hi, welcome. Knock, knock, wakey, wakey, let's go. It's 6 a.m., time to go churn something. Knocker-uppers would sleep during the day, and they would wake up at like 4 in the afternoon. They weren't worried about sleeping in at all. We could rely on these guys. But if the knocker-upper slept in, then what? We'd all be screwed. We'd be sleeping forever. No one would wake up ever again. Imagine waking up every day by a stick being smacked against your window. How jarring would that be? No wonder everybody smoked in Peaky Blinders. I'd be so stressed out too every single day. Go to bed. Nope, see you tomorrow. Yep, someone's gonna smack on my window at any point. Number 4, the Leech Collector. I always enjoyed catching frogs growing up. You could probably tell just by looking at me, but apparently I have to step my game up. Yeah, a leech collector is just that. It sounds exactly like what you think. Back when medicine was pretty much non-existent and sickness was just wafting out throughout all these towns, leeches were considered medical equipment. Leeches, we need a big bucket of leeches. The classic, oh, if you feel sick, maybe try bleeding for a bit solution. You know, one of those? They would use horse legs to lure out these leeches, but most of the time, these guys would have to just get in and swim around themselves and touch as much as they can, trying to make contact with as many leeches as they can. These guys must have fainted so often. The loss of blood was intense, and on top of that, you gotta look out for the same reason we need leeches in the first place. Disease. Yeah, these guys were in ponds gulping this disease water, catching leeches. Meanwhile, I'm complaining about bussing tables. Imagine that. Number 3, Lector. Long before Spotify, even before the miracle worker that was LimeWire, rest in peace LimeWire, always good, and FrostWire, you're also good. Factory workers needed entertainment to distract themselves from the repetitive, horrible tasks every day, the 9-to-5. I mean, we're talking about a time where women would make arsenic dresses, okay? They obviously didn't have a Google Home set up in the corner, it was all bad at that point. But come 1929, workers aren't treated like complete trash, so now they brought in the Lector. The Lector would read news or literature out loud to the workers. It sounds like a nice gesture when you think about it, but cigar factory workers would have to pitch in portions of their own pay in order to fund these guys. They would have to make less money to hear Joe Rogan rant in the corner about politics all day. Yeah, that's not gonna fly, not everybody is on board. So there of course were many cases where thousands of workers would go on strike because this dude wouldn't shut up. I mean, some cases, sure, entertain away, but if you need to focus all day, maybe you're working with small parts or like needles, it's kinda hard to get your job done when all you hear is, and I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down. Okay, next chapter, guys. Keep it up. You're doing great. Number 2, no rules football. Sports fans are a bit much. The whole yelling at the TV thing, look, unless it's the Green Goblin, I'm not gonna be vocal towards my television set. That's it. I'm just built different. I don't know. I'm not as into it. But sportsmanship, that goes back, way back. Football was a lot different in the late 12th century. Instead of corner kicks and throw-ins, you could do anything you wanted to retrieve the ball from the opposing team. Elbows, knees, headbutts, anything. Also, there's no limit to how many players you could have on your side. So towns would just pretty much fist fight each other, and then in the middle of it, there would be a ball rolling around, and they would say, hey, it's a sport, it's football. Finally, come 1314, King Edward II banned the game. The only time diving was allowed, I'd say, was definitely back in these days, when you'd get kicked in the neck. Then it's fair to hit the deck, I'd say, and act like you're unconscious. Then dive away, for sure. And finally, number one, jesters. The earliest accounts of the fool go back to the 11th century. These fools were hired to liven up the party. Most of you may have an image of a jester in your head as soon as I said their names, just jumping around on tables, you know, boom, boom, a lot of leg up stuff. It was one of the best jobs to have back in the day. The title of a minstrel or a fool, it was an honor to have. The fool's payment was also no joke. Roland Le Patour was rewarded with 30 acres of land from King Henry II as long as he showed up to court every year on Christmas Day to fart. Yeah, he would whistle, jump around, and fart all over the place. Imagine eating beans on Christmas Day with your family, having a nice time, then Roland jumps on the table, starts farting all over your grandma, then leaps over your head and leaves. What kind of Christmas is that? I'd be so upset. I'd be like, get that guy back here. He's farting on my grandma. Roland the Farter, that was his nickname, pretty fitting. How great is that? He would also whistle tunes in your face while he was dancing around. This was a job, a high-paying job. Nothing but air in this dude. Holy. Those are some more unusual things that are too woke for this era, but of course, if you want a part three, comment down below and I'll come back and do the rest. I've been Taylor McWaters and we'll see you next time on Bumblebee. Peace. Why'd I do that? I was like, see ya.